Hi, and welcome back to Fuller's Figures. Today I'm going to take a look at the new G.I. Joe classified series, Torpedo. Again, another figure I've been really excited about getting because they've done an awesome job on this figure by all accounts, looking from the imagery we've seen online over the past couple of months. Now, Torpedo is not a figure that I ever actually had growing up. I did have a couple of the different Action Force scuba divers, which of course were the five POA line that we got here before we got the multiple articulated international heroes as we knew them over here, but they were G.I. Joe in the States. So I'm dying to get this guy out, have a look, see what he's like compared to those retro figures. You can see then he comes with this cool artwork on the box. They've done a good job on these plastic free packaging boxes, that it's all sort of cardboard. We get a great look at the figure here on this diorama. We've got sort of a submarine on the back, and we've got the cobra snakes coming up through these tubes here. We get sort of an animated image of the character here, and on this strip we get to see the accessories that come with Torpedo. Side of the box then, we get that image carried around again with this QR code along with the file card. So obviously the QR code maybe brings you to the website to decode what these different symbols are. This side here then, we just get a larger image of that sort of animated image there from the side, which is pretty awesome. He's number 73 in the line. I better get that in. Top of the box is just the G.I. Joe logo. Bottom of the box is some legal jargon along with some plastic free packaging propaganda. Back in the box, we get this size comparison. So we can see that Torpedo is 6 inches tall. We get to see the individual accessories that come with Torpedo. And we get a close up then of some of the cool little design features that exist on the figure itself. Bottom of the box, more legal jargon. So let's get this fella out, have a closer look at him, see what the accessories are like, and I'll tell you what I think is his playability factor. So I've got Torpedo out of his packaging here, and then a lot like Copperhead, we can see that they've carried that imagery onto the inside of the box, which is a nice touch to get. So again, we get these little paper or cardboard sort of straps that loosen up fairly easily, so they shouldn't be putting too much pressure on the figure's limbs. Doesn't want to come away from you. There we go. And normally once you loosen them, the figure should pop out fairly free. So wow, this guy looks pretty awesome. Can't wait to get a closer look at him. This, of course, then is his locker. So we can see it's got his number 73 on it there. We get the G.I. Joe logo on the front here. And again, just a nice bit of a design around that to show it's a foot locker. We get the baggie of accessories, and we get more legal jargon. Buying an action figure nowadays is like signing a big contract inside a solicitor's or a lawyer's office, isn't it, huh? Anyway, so inside the baggie, get these open and have a look at the accessories. And just making extra sure that I'm not throwing any accessories out with that. So let me get this guy set up. I'll stick him on the spinny wheel and we'll take a closer look at him. Here's Torpedo out of the packaging now, and I have him up on my spinny wheel on display here in the pose. I'm using the fire effects from the Viper 3 pack, and I have to say, this figure comes with an awful lot. He's action packed with accessories. He looks awesome. I just want to fill the bathtub and jump in and play with this guy, just like I did back in the day when I had the Action Force scuba divers. This figure is phenomenal. I'm really impressed with it. So I'm looking forward to getting them down and taking a closer look at some of the more details on the figure and the accessories. Taking a closer look then at Torpedo, and we can see a lot, like I said, with the Copperhead figure, the face sculpt, although not a full head sculpt, is a vast improvement on some of the ones we've been getting recently. And they've done a really good job capturing the look of this guy, just sort of a sense of realism in the sculpt of the face and on the paintwork. And I think they've done an excellent job on that. The overall bulk of the figure is quite slender, which you'd expect, I suppose, for a swimming character or a scuba diver, and I really like the way that they've done that they've sort of toned it down from the muscular figures we've been getting in the line. Not a lot to him then, I suppose, insofar as the body is just his wetsuit, but there's loads of little details hidden around it that just make this guy stand out off the shelf, that he's not just playing. So we can see he's wearing this harness over his shoulders here, and they've molded on a couple of pouches here in red, which is nice. We have another one here in black, and again it stands out from the grey, which is a nice touch. And then a black belt buckle here in the middle to show that that's where the straps are buckled onto him. So look, really nice little touches like that, and that's carried out throughout the figure. Coming down then, this is one I was really impressed with on his arm here. So we get his diving gauge, so that would be a watch and something to monitor his oxygen levels with. So that's pretty nice. There's a little display screen here with some sort of logo on it to show something's been displayed. So if he was checking out his oxygen levels, that's where he's going to go to. So that's a nice touch as well. Harness at the back then is just plain in the grey colour, which is fine because there's enough on the front to give it some definition. We come down then and he has this belt which is moulded onto the bottom part of the body. It has a nice little logo on it here, and then a couple of pouches moulded around in the grey colour. Again, another nice touch. Down to the legs, not an awful lot. It's just the wetsuit continued down in two tones, but it is a muted tone. It's not high gloss, which is nice. Unfortunately, it's a bit glossier on the abdomen than it is on the rest of the body, but I do like the sort of matte look of the suit. He has a sheet on this side here for his dive knife, and then on this side here they've added this little sort of pockets which sits onto or strapped onto his leg there, so he'd have other bits and bobs in that. So again, like I said, a much slender looking figure, but I do like what they've done with it. I won't go into all the articulation because it's the same as we get with all the other G.I. Joes, which is excellent. And book-wise, I'm really impressed with Torpedo. So let's look at accessories, and I suppose we'll start with his backpack or his oxygen tank. It's just starting off, it's got this grey moulded piece here, but you can see it's moulded in the shape of the back of his body. And then it has the oxygen tank on the back here. So not a typical oxygen tank. This is possibly a rebreather, which would be more, I suppose, attuned to a character like that that's going on long underwater missions. At first glance, it doesn't look like there's a lot to it. It's just two colours. But as you get in closer, you can see the sort of little tubes and valves moulded around it, which do give a nice sort of sense of realism on it. And it does stand out, and that's pretty neat. Hooks onto a peg on the back. You can see it's a snug fit to the body, and it's a good fit. It's not going to fall off. Sticking with the swimming team then, and I suppose a quick look at his flippers. We can see these are just molded in black, but they have this maroon paint application here on the front, and a few little details molded around, but I suppose you wouldn't get too much on a pair of flippers. And these just are a soft kind of rubber and hook onto the leg like that. So grand and flexible and easy to fit onto the figure. I'll just get the second one on there now. And while I'm on camera, of course, the back of the heel piece is struggling. There we go. So that's his flippers ready to dive into the water. Next thing then, I suppose, is the scuba mask and the goggles. Have a lovely silver decal on them, so you get a nice reflection of them there. We have the air intake piece here, the mouthpiece, with again another little maroon paint up on either side of it, and some more silver paint apps here where the air bubbles would come out. So that's nice and neat. Now this slots really easy over his head, and it has these tubes with a little pin on them that connect onto the top of the tank like so. So really, really good luck to the character. Next thing we get then is his dive knife. So just molded in black with a maroon handle, but there is some nice details in the handle itself. You can see where it has the grip on it there, and then it has this serrated edge on top, and it's molded to give it sort of a razor sharp look on the blade of the knife on the bottom there. So that's a really nice looking dive knife. And the little sheet then on the right leg allows that to slot in. Now I'm not sure would a diver wear a knife up this high, or would they keep it maybe down on near the ankle, but it fits in nice and neat, and again, nice snug fit. The other accessories he comes with then is this here, which is his little sort of submachine gun, which is just molded in all black, but does have some nice little molds or sculpts on it. It comes with a magazine then that, if you put it in the right way, slots in like so. And again, that has some sort of little details on it there, which is nice. My one criticism of this, it's a very soft plastic. It's near rubber. So you can see there's an awful bend in it there. It's very durable. So I suppose on the one hand, it's not going to break on you and you can straighten it out. But I just wish there was a bit more rigidity to the weapon, and particularly the next one I show you as well. But that's the little submachine gun. Lastly, then he comes with this harpoon, which you can see has the yellow strap here for he holds over his shoulder or on his wrist so he doesn't lose it in the water. Again, just molded all in black for the rest of it, with the cable coming up here tied over the top into the harpoon head, which has a nice silver decal on it. A lot like the submachine gun, you can see there's an awful bend in this. I have been sort of messing, trying to straighten it out. It's the, again, same sort of rubbery material, which it would have been nice if it was a bit more rigid, a bit more straight, but on the other hand, I suppose it's not going to break on you. But that looks pretty cool. And I suppose the other point of the rubber then, that if you want to put it over, you can get it up as far as his shoulder. It will take a little bit of stretch there, so you can see if he was in the water, that would be sort of maybe floating above him or under him. So some nice accessories, and really do add to the look of the figure. I think they've done an excellent job on those accessories. And that's been my look at Torpedo. So overall, I think they're bang on with the accessories that come with this figure. The aesthetics of the figure are really on point. I think the look of the figure really does have a callback to those Action Force scuba divers I used to have as a kid. And again, the articulation is just amazing with these G.I. Joe action figures. So I have no real complaints. The only complaint I had, I suppose, is the bendability of a couple of the weapons he comes with. But outside that, this figure's on point. Still a reasonable price on these figures too. So I'm going to give this guy a playability factor of 9 out of 10. So far, I'm really impressed with what's coming of late from the G.I. Joe classified line. And this guy's no exception. I've thoroughly enjoyed getting this figure out and messing about with him. And look forward to taking some more photographs with him. Thank you so much for watching my video. I really appreciate it. If you want, you can follow me over on Instagram at Fuller's Figures, where I like to post fairly regularly. And if nothing else, I really hope I see you on the next one.